This tutorial will show you how to work with node functions and defaults. Node functions and defaults are a powerful MapForce feature that enables you to standardize the processing of nodes in a structure. This is very useful because you can apply the same processing logic to multiple descendant items at once, without repeating the same function multiple times in your mapping. Let's take a look at a concrete example. This is our source XML file that shows a book order. This file has quite a few issues. First of all the price values are pretty clunky, so we want to round them all up. Secondly, most of the string nodes have a lot of white space that we want to trim. And thirdly, some nodes are missing. And this is the output we want to get. This file looks very nice and neat. The price values have been rounded up, and all the necessary spaces have been trimmed. All the fields that were empty now have these new default values. Moreover, the output includes dollar signs for all the price values. So how do we achieve such results? We can use standard ways of creating a mapping. This means that we will have to add a lot of functions to process individual nodes. And look how cumbersome the mapping has become. And a much better approach is to use node functions and defaults. This simple and effective solution can help avoid clutter in our mapping and make it much easier to understand. This is the example we are going to discuss in this tutorial. Thus, our major goal is to standardize the processing of decimal and string nodes in our mapping. Our data source is an XML file with a schema definition. Let's add our data source to the mapping. Our target component is a fixed-length field text file that doesn't exist yet. We will create and configure this file directly in the mapping. Let's add a text component. We will name the component order details. And the format is fixed. Our text component will consist of 8 fields. And the first one is called title. This field is a string and will have a length of 60 characters. By trial and error, we have found that this is the ideal value for this field. Let's continue creating other fields. Now all our fields are ready and we can carry on with our mapping. In the next step, we will connect the book element and the rows node. Let's take a look at the output. As you can see, our data is in complete disarray, so our next task will be to standardize the processing of the decimal nodes, and we will deal with the string nodes a bit later. To apply the same processing logic to all the decimal nodes, we will create a node function. To create a node function, we will right-click the book node, and then select the output option from the context menu. As soon as we do this, the node functions and defaults window opens. Each component has its own window for defining node functions and defaults. We will add a node function by clicking this button over here. As soon as we add the node function definition area appears. A node function has one input parameter and one output parameter. By default, the All Descendant Items option is selected. Actually, you can choose to apply the rule only to direct children or to all descendants. We want this function to apply only to decimals. The next step is to add the round precision function. Then let's connect the raw value to the value of the function. For the decimals parameter, we will use a constant. The value of the constant is 1. Let's connect the constant with the decimals parameter. And then the result with the output. Since most of our price values have a lot of decimal numbers after the decimal point, we will round up these numbers to the first digit after the decimal point. The definition of the node function is now complete. Let's go back to the main mapping window. Now we can observe some changes in our source component. The function icons have popped up next to the nodes the rule applies to. Let's take a look at the output. All the price values have successfully been rounded up. The only problem is the text values have also been rounded up, which of course is not our goal. So let's exclude the text element from processing. Let's first click the text element, and then clear the checkbox Inherit Rules from Ancestors. The function icon has changed to reflect the new setting. Let's check the output again. Now all the text values are back to normal. Since the amount element is an integer, the round precision function has no bearing on it, so this node can stay as is. Besides rounding up the price values, we also want to add a dollar sign to each price value in the output. In order to do this, we will define a node function for the price nodes in the tired component. The reason for processing the price nodes in two stages is the following. The price nodes in the source file are decimals, and the price nodes in the target are strings. Since the price nodes are different data types in the source and target, we can't perform calculations in string concatenation for the same component. Therefore, we first batch process the decimals of the source component, and now we can deal with the price nodes in the target. Since the node functions and defaults window is already open, we will simply click the rows node. This will cause this window to apply to the target component. Then we will add a node function. The next step is set the concat function. For the first value, we will use a constant. For string values, we first need to add a double quotation mark, and then the value itself, which is the dollar sign in our case, and then press enter. Let's connect the constant to value 1, and then the input to value 2, and then the result of the output. The function will apply to string nodes. Let's take a look at the output. We can see that each price value has a dollar sign in front of it, but unfortunately all the other strings also have dollar signs. So let's go back to our node function and fix this. To exclude the string nodes we do not want, we'll use a regular expression. Let's click the ellipsis button next to the string. Then we will select the filter bar and regular expression options. And then we will enter the following expression. This expression will look for price nodes which can have any number and any combination of characters before and after the price bit. The search is case insensitive. Let's check the output. As you can see, only the price values have the dollar signs in front of them. Our next goal is to deal with whitespace and our string values. Let's go back to the main mapping window. Now let's click the book node to switch to the node functions for the source component. We will create a node function that will apply only to strings. Now let's add the normalize space function. Then we need to connect the input with the function. And after that, the result with the output. Let's take a look at the output. As you can see, all the leading and trailing spaces, as well as all the unnecessary spaces inside the strings, have been trimmed. Our last goal is to supply a default value that will replace all the empty fields. To add a default, we will click this green button. The rule will apply only to strings. And now we will type the following default value. Let's take a look at the output. All the fields that were previously empty now have these new values. The definition of the node functions and defaults is now complete. You can test all the MapForce features yourself. Simply download a fully featured 30-day free trial from the Altova website.